Hello everyone! In this lesson, you will learn about randomness and pseudorandomness in cryptography. This lesson will cover the need for and sources of random and pseudorandom number sequences and how important it is to test their quality. The security of operation of many cryptographic applications relies on the unpredictability of certain quantities generated every time they're used. The examples are countless, including the key in the one-time pad, the secret key for symmetric encryption, the parameters of the RSA, and auxiliary quantities for digital signature generation. The quantities used in cryptographic applications must be of sufficient length and look like a random sequence, in a sense that the probability distribution of generated values must be as close as possible to uniform. In the previous lesson, you have seen how much time it would take to brute force a 256-bit long randomly generated key. For that to be true, however, the underlying source of randomness that produced the key should not give an adversary a chance to reduce the amount of work required to uncover the key, based on the probabilities of some values of the keys being selected more often than the others. Probably the first thing that comes to mind when talking about a chance outcome is coin flipping. With the outcomes encoded as 0 or 1, each flip of a fair coin produces one or the other with the probability of exactly 50%. The flips are also independent of each other. The result of any previous coin flip does not affect future coin flips. The unbiased coin is thus the perfect random bitstream generator, and the value of the next element in the sequence cannot be predicted, regardless of how many times the coin has already been flipped. A random bit generator is an algorithm or a physical device that produces a sequence of statistically independent and unbiased binary digits. A true random bit generator requires a naturally occurring source of randomness in some physical phenomena. A famous, though somehow surprising one, is a lava lamp, because the movements of the liquids inside are chaotic. Genuine randomness, however, is extremely rare to come by. A fundamental, unpredictable, and principal source of pure randomness could be a quantum mechanical event, or nuclear decay of atoms, fluctuations in the vacuum, state changes of qubits. Devices making use of such physical occurrences of randomness are called hardware-based generators. Personal computers often read from physical sources of randomness measured by their sensors, such as thermal noise, air turbulence while using a hard drive, environmental noises detected by a microphone, etc. Unpredictable quantities, such as secret keys, needed in cryptographic algorithms should ideally be obtained from such truly random sources. However, in practice, it is extremely hard to produce truly random bits as quickly and as large as needed. Often, access to a high-quality randomness source is limited as well, like in smart cards. And for such cases, pseudorandom number generators are used. Pseudorandom number generator is a deterministic algorithm that takes a truly random seed and expands it into a much longer bit sequence, which is statistically indistinguishable from a random sequence. The length of the seed should be sufficient for an attempt to search over all possible seeds to be practically impossible. In the generated sequence, the next output should not be predictable from any amount of the previous outputs available to the adversary. There are many ways to design an algorithm for pseudorandom number generation. Different systems and frameworks tend to choose for themselves the most suitable design for the purpose, or support several types of them. A simple and widely used class is linear congruential generators, which produce a sequence of numbers based on a linear recurrence as follows, where the first x is a secret random seed. Such generators can be defined like this. And the first 10 pseudorandom numbers that will produce from the seed 1 by repeated evaluation would be these. On a large scale, the numbers produced do look as if they were uniformly distributed in random, even though you know they were computed using a deterministic algorithm. The Wolfram language's default way to generate unpredictable bit sequences of arbitrary lengths is to simulate the evolution of a cellular automaton and take its central vertical line. For instance, the illustrated are the first 150 steps of the evolution of the rule 30, starting from a single black cell. There are various statistical tests designed to evaluate the quality of pseudorandom number generator. These tests help detect flaws in the generator may have and determine whether the sequence of bits possesses features of a truly random sequence, like the hypothetical output of an unbiased coin. A basic test is a frequency test. It checks that the number of zeros and ones in the sequence, and any subsequence, is roughly the same. A 2-bit test checks that the number of occurrences of 00, 01, 10, or 11 is roughly the same in the sequence or any of its subsequences. A runs test checks that the total number of runs in the sequence, where a run is an uninterrupted sequence of identical bits, is approximately half of the length of the sequence. These tests look at the various properties of the bit sequence to ensure that there is no way to correctly distinguish between the output sequence of a generator and a truly random sequence of the same length. If in addition to this there is no algorithm to predict the next bits of output from any previous bits, then such a generator can be considered a cryptographically secure pseudorandom bit generator. There are other SORO statistical tests available at Wolfram Function Repository, and more extensive information on statistical tests can be found in a NIST special publication cited in your further reading section. Adequate testing of the quality of underlying sources of randomness is crucial for cryptographic applications. History has known many episodes where a mathematically unbreakable algorithm, at least yet, could not guarantee the security of the systems around it due to unsatisfactory usage of random number generators. Often, such episodes led to financial losses. For example, one of Bitcoin's vulnerabilities that has leaked more than 1,000 private keys over time was a result of faulty usage of randomness. When digitally signing their transactions, some users would reuse an auxiliary random quantity more than once, essentially allowing anyone to compute their private key from signature value. The same sort of accident has also happened with the Sony PlayStation 3, when a group of hackers was able to compute the private key needed to sign off a high-level operations because they basically used a constant number instead of generating a random one every time. In the previous cases, the issue was that the same number was reused instead of being randomized every time. However, even when the values are in fact pseudorandom, one has to ensure that the underlying source is of high quality. Earlier, we have defined a linear congruential generator, which had seemingly random output. The parameters A, B, and M presented are those of the infamous generator Randu. First of all, it only produces odd numbers, which does not make it quite random. And moreover, if outputs are looked as triplets, the previous output, the current one, and the next one, it can be clearly seen that these points only fall into several planes, which cannot be considered random. And for comparison, here is the same plot for the Wolfram language's default pseudorandom number generator based on cellular automata. In the next lessons, you will see that the need for good pseudorandom output occurs in almost any cryptographic application.